At 1st October, I'm not one of the main organizers anyway, but I can tell you. There was organized in a very kind of anarchistical way a festival with a lot of circus artists, malabarists, skaters, musicians. A lot of trucks came from the whole Europe to Barcelona, and we spot a place on Zona Franca, a place owned by one of the Partido Popular main leaders here on Barcelona, who was responsible of mainly all the speculation on the forum. So we entered to the place, we started making some places for the skates, arranged the place, we put a couple of tents, a big one, the freak show, another one, and we cleaned the whole place like 3 days. And the day in which the festival was supposed to start at the 7 morning, they arrived kind of 20 vans, but most of the squadra that are local police here in Catalonia. And national police too, and they had anti-disturbios. What's the name in English? The bad ones.
Anti-disturbios?
Like, yeah, with protection for demonstrations.
All right.
The black ones.
Right.
With the
special squads.
Okay, that fucking awesome.
Anyway, Star Wars.
It was kind of 20 vans and more waiting and a lot of policemen, and they broke down tents.
This happened on October 1st.
There were little children, because you know these travelers.
They are children, but the
quiet type, they travel with children. They put the house. They were making the day before were like biking, little children's biking. They were so scared.
The singer.
Yes, David, one of the dancers of Ojos de Brujo, our group here Barcelona musicians.
And then the
people of the place, they arranged it because we have a lot of material. We couldn't get out from there, even if we wanted, because we had big trucks that weren't there. So there were people who had to wait more, but they took almost all of us out. And the most scary thing was the big operation they made for not letting them get into Barcelona. They took
the highways
were blocked, and not any van could enter to Barcelona with kind of a geary guy traveling. No.
And sound system. Yeah.
The guys had to stop on
La Junquera,
kind of 40 kilometers from here.
Oh my God!
They weren't allowed to go back because they didn't want to let them settle down in any place.
But at Plaza Catalunya the next day, the Saturday.
So we made the big thing there.
Ojos de Brujo in a
track.
They start to sing
in Plaza Catalunya. We made a demonstration with the band, and we take it with a very kind of famous group here on the whole state and in Catalunya too, called Ojos de Brujo, Witch Eyes. So they sung on the demonstration. We wanted to go to the mayor's
council
house.
Yeah.
Well, we went to
para un escrache.
Yeah. We wanted to escracharlo.
Friday, we closed the Gran Vía.
Yeah,
we closed
bikes. La marcha esta de las bicicletas.
Because we had critical mass. Friday we have critical mass here. So that Friday the critical mass should have supposed to be ending on the theater festival. The critical mass uh, uh, will we're supposed to lead the people to the place, a kind of secret place. Well, it was not published
the route,
but yeah, a lot of people came to help anyway, and we were not hiding us there because it was just a soil. It was nothing in there. It was a big square of terrain, and in a part we had like a building, like una nave. I don't know how to say it in English. A big industrial building without anything in there. Just big.
And you put it there or
just
no?
And we wanted to use that part for visuals because it was dark, and all the place where people taking all the dust for the skates. We got tents up, but big tents, circus tents. It was a very nice place. We had our shows anyway because we could saw all the.
But so what happened with all the bicycles? Just went into the highway instead and stopped the highway.
But it was a moment in which we couldn't afford to make the festival in any other place because they broke down a lot of material from the artists. We have now a big deuda.
Yeah.
We owe a lot of money. We are making some shows.
And we are making parties to
raise some money.
Kind of 28,000, no.
How much?
What? 20,000.
Yeah. Wow.
Because they broke down a lot of material.
And another material disappeared, and part of them. Some money from the festival, it was to pay the artists
who came from a long ways.
And nobody paid the entrance.
So we
had to pay them anyway.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of losses. Not as thickable as the numbers, but there was people working like 8 months making amazing
puppets,
landscapes. Yes, and robots and machines with all recycled material. They've been making them on different places.
To
set up. It was kind of monstrous place, that kind of a marvelous place with horses that throw fire
and more
cycles with big wheels.
Shit.
It was very nice.
And there was no way to negotiate with
the
city?
They broke down everything, so people had to work again 8 months.
Y la carreta, la carreta está una cosa.
Sí, it was like a big.
Sí.
It was like on carnivals, like on Rio, but kind of cyberpunk.
Yeah.
Y está la policía aún. Esta la lleva la grúa. Yes, they took a lot of material, they have it yet.
Yo sé que pagarlo, eso cuando vayas a
haber que
pagarlo, yo supongo que habrá un máximo.
We have to take it up and we don't have the money because the police took it up.
If you have your vehicle for a long time, you have to pay more and more.
No,
since
they will
October.
Keep it. Yeah, you can afford it. So we can do another one, you know, anyway. It's cheaper.
Because it's cheaper.
We took it from the street.
Oh,
no.
But you think they have it still, or they destroyed it?
No, I don't know. I think it's like kind of the on the moment it was very important. They broke down everything and they took everything they could. But now I don't think they keep it. I think they have to anyway. But it's the way they are doing it now. When they entered to La Hansa, it was the same.
Pero los vecinos.
Ah, sí.
Sí, y lo han venido a quitar y lo han vuelto a plantar
en ese en esta película de OVNI, yo lo he visto.
Claro.
Sí.
Pues este es el parque que han hecho con los vecinos. Y acá toda esta parte también está arreglada por los vecinos. Y en los días del taller de bicis sacan de ahí un montón de bicis que tienen, de armazones y ruedas uh-huh. y todo, y las ponen aquí en la calle. Y tú puedes venir y montarte una bici. Uh-huh. Y hay gente que sabe de arreglar bicis y te van enseñando y te van explicando cómo va. Hay una chica que explica súper bien de bicicletas. Y es como hacker, pero de bicis.
Ah, hacker de bicis.
Y hay free highway.